I think looking back in hindsight, the meetings with Adams were another arm for the IRA to be able to keep me in my box. We weren't going to go outside of their parameters and tell people what had happened. You weren't going to go and report it.
She says the meeting was the first of several with Gerry Adams about her allegations of sexual abuse.
Part of that conversation surrounded, you know, the usual, you need to look after yourself. I love you. We love you. You know you can come to me at any time and I'll help you out. And there was another bit of conversation that went on generally about Gerry and how Gerry knew all about sexual abuse and the devastating effects that it could have on people. And I looked out the window at the traffic going past behind him and a tourist bus had pulled up. I always remember it because it was really surreal. There were people out taking photographs of the office that the two of us were sitting in. And at that point then, yes, it did kind of hit me that I was sitting with the person who was the head, the public figure of the Republican movement. But the most disturbing thing of that conversation for me was then he said, well, you know, Maria, abusers can be extremely manipulative. And, you know, and he kind of put his hand on his chin and he sat forward a wee bit and he said, sometimes they're that manipulative that the people who have been abused actually enjoy it. I was absolutely horrified. And I, at that point, got very, very angry and said to him, well, I didn't enjoy it. And at that, the meeting was over for me. There was no point.
During that meeting, did you get a sense that he had distanced himself from the actions of the IRA?
He apologised on behalf of the Republican movement for what had happened to me.
What was he sorry for?
Well, again, ask him. Because for me, it was very clear that Gerry was not apologising on behalf of Sinn Féin. Gerry was apologising for the IRA actions in relation to what happened with me.
By speaking out publicly, are you in effect just trying to damage Sinn Féin?
No. You know, I really, at this stage, couldn't give two hoots what happens to Sinn Féin or what they do. Again, we're back to the issue of responsibility and frustration and cover-up. And I think there has been a colossal attempt to cover this issue up.